Hey, I'm pretty sure most of you will easily recognize this machine. And guess what? You may even be able to win it. Stay until the end to discover how. Welcome to 3Dnatives Lab. I'm Elliot, and today we'll be reviewing a printer from one of the most hyped FDM consumer brands on the market. I'm of course talking about Bambu Lab, and we'll be taking a look at the P1S. Bambu Lab is a very young player in the additive manufacturing landscape. And despite only being founded in 2020, it has made quite a name for itself, particularly on social media. But how have they been able to make such a splash? Well, the X1 series, the first range of 3D printer, launched in 2022 through a record-breaking Kickstarter campaign, raising an astonishing amount of over $7 million. What really stands out with Bambu Lab's 3D printers is their use of AI and advanced functionalities to improve user experience. The other key factor to Bambu Lab's success is the fact that the entire machine, AMS and advanced capabilities come in at just shy of $1,000. Currently, their product range is made up of four 3D printers, the X1 Carbon, the X1, the P1P, and the P1S. The P1S, being the newest addition to the product range, will explore how it compares to its predecessors, as well as discover how well it performs. Let's get right into our review. Now that we have introduced you to Bambu Lab and the P1S, let's get more technical by taking a look at its specs. As we mentioned before, the four Bambu Lab printers share most of the same components. The P1S, along with the others, has an overall footprint of 389 by 399 by 458 mm and comes with a welded steel chassis providing a build volume of 256 mm cubed, which is decent but relatively small compared to market standards. They are all equipped with a CoreXY motion system and a proprietary hot end which rides on a carbon rod, reduce the weight of the gantry, theoretically enabling accelerations of up to 20,000 mm per second squared during printing. On top of these components, the printers use an analog force sensor which probes the bed from the tip of the nozzle, thus eliminating the need for baby stepping and ensuring optimal first layer adhesion. Overall, it is pretty evident that the P1S is a mid-range offering as it bridges the gap between the P1P and the X1 series in many ways. The first thing you'll notice is that contrary to the P1P, the P1S comes fully enclosed. It is made up of plastic side and back panels as well as a glass top cover and front door. Second is that the P1S shares its simplistic monochromatic screen and button interface with the P1P, lacking the X1 series polished color touchscreen. However, the P1S includes a few benefits over the P1P, and it comes with the auxiliary part cooling fan, chamber temperature regulated fan, an activated carbon air filter, which are all also found on the X1 printers. The flagship X1 series still reigns over and offers advanced AI functions, micro LiDAR and improved camera sensor, as well as aluminium side and back panels instead of the plastic ones found on the P1S. The AMS, or Automatic Material System, is definitely one of the key highlights of the Bambu Lab ecosystem. It can house four spools of filaments in a dry environment and enable multi-material printing as well as easy material swaps, as all of the spools remain ready to print, allowing to simply select the desired material when starting a print. It integrates smoothly in the manufacturer's ecosystem and allows for daisy chaining of up to 4 units thanks to the AMS hub, resulting in up to 16 colors 3D printed. Furthermore, the AMS automatically recognizes Bambu Lab filaments thanks to their integrated NFC chips, allowing the slicing profiles to sync through the glass. Bambu Lab has clearly also put some effort into the software to improve user experience. The manufacturer implemented input shaping, a method democratized by the Vron design team and Clipper firmware. It uses an accelerometer fitted on the printhead to measure the resonance frequency of the printer and actively compensates for any ringing or ghosting artifacts. The proprietary slicer, Bambu Studio, is a fork of the well-known Prusa slicer, which is itself an offshoot from Slick3R. It uses Prusa Slicer's slicing engine whilst offering a revamped user interface. It comes with pre-configured profiles for all their printers and filaments, as well as third-party machines and materials. Being built on the foundations of Prusa Slicer, it features all of its basic as well as advanced functionalities. Bambu Lab also added a few notable features in an attempt to make printing easier and preventing potential user errors. These features include auto-orientation, multi-build plate slicing, text embossing and extrusion, assembly view, as well as different pop-ups, giving the user guidelines to avoid potential issues like material compatibility, steep unsupported overhangs, and more. The printers can be connected via Wi-Fi to Bambu Lab's cloud service, which is accessible directly through Bambu Studio, or thanks to their Android and iOS apps called Bambu Handy. In our testing, connecting the printer to the slicer is pretty much necessary, as the P1S's built-in screen only provides a basic interface and quite limited functionalities during operation. Now, let's move on to the exciting part, the prints themselves. And wow, printing is made so easy with the P1S. In our testing, the printer proved very easy to use. Straight out of the box, and without any manual tuning, we were able to achieve good printing results. The Core XY motion system, combined with the printer's impressive acceleration, results in fast and precise prints. During our tests, we achieved tolerances of up to 0.1 mm. One of the few drawbacks we did notice during testing is that despite the slicer providing an option to detect the build plate when launching a print, this feature didn't work for us. As such, prints could be started without the print bed installed, and the printer didn't realize anything was wrong. Additionally, the printer could be somewhat loud, mainly due to the auxiliary part cooling fan. The AMS, which is included in the P1S combo bundle, and the enclosure offer wide material compatibility and a seamless experience when working with multiple materials. As such, we were able to print with PLA, FETG, ABS, ASA, and TPU during our testing. A handy feature we had never experienced before is the auto-unloading of filaments after each print, which comes in very handy when swapping filaments, as spools can be swapped in just a few seconds in the AMS. Another convenience is the built-in camera, which allows for easy monitoring and time-lapse recording. In conclusion, Bambu Lab P1S is a feature-rich 3D printer that delivers user-friendliness and precise prints. Its well-polished hardware and software experience allow for a seamless printing process. Its fully enclosed design, automatic material system, and speed make it an attractive option for a wide range of applications and materials. All in all, the P1S delivers on Bambu Lab's promises and proves the manufacturer stands up to the hype. While it's not without a few drawbacks, such as the dated built-in screen and the noise during operation, the P1S's positives definitely outweigh the negatives. As mentioned in the beginning of this video, the P1S and AMS combo comes in just shy of $1,000 at $950. The printer alone is $750, and the P1P can be upgraded to benefit from all the P1S's added features for $150. After a few weeks of testing and emptying various pools of filament in the AMS, we rated the P1S and gave it a total score of 9.75 out of 10. To see the breakdown of the score, don't miss our written article. On top of the additional info about our testing with the P1S, you can enter the giveaway through the form in our written review in any of the 5 languages we cover. Thank you for joining us in this review of the Bambu Lab P1S. Feel free to leave any questions or comments down below. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more 3D printing content. See you soon in the next video.